We continue here at the St. Joseph School Fair, which in Ponchatoula has really become an event in its own right. I mean, a festival, by any definition of the word, nobody knows that any better than Strader Cieutat. We were talking about, and of course, your maiden name is Dewfresh. How many generations of Dewfreshes have been involved in this annual event?
Oh, gosh. Well, we've been part of St. Joseph's family since the beginning. So, 1800s, to be honest with you. My dad was a graduate. All my Dewfresh uncles and my aunt, my grandfather, my great uncle Brent. And yeah, you know, and the legacy continues because my children also graduated from St. Joseph's.
Well, in the meantime, you're running for parish council in a new district that has a little more of Ponchatoula itself than the old district. It goes from here out into Pumpkin Center.
Yes, and I'm really excited about that. I've lived in the Ponchatoula city limits most of my life. My husband and I recently moved out to the west side of town about 8 years ago. So I feel like I know a lot about the city limits. I know a lot about what's on the west side of town and what those needs are. So I'm very excited about that.
Well, turning to the parish council, the most recent issue that faced is half-acre lots for new subdivisions. And, you know, it surprised a lot of us that they would have gone that far in restricting growth, but they did.
I think desperate times call for desperate measures sometimes, and the feedback that the parish council has been getting from everyone is we need to do something to try and curb all of the homes that are going up. And so one of the things that the council decided that would work best was to increase the lot sizes. And I think that's great, especially for families. You know, whenever you get married young or you're building young, you build what you can afford. And as you get older, typically you begin having a family and you want to have a bigger home or of a yard, and you grow out of those smaller homes. So this is giving people an opportunity to have larger homes, larger lot sizes, to have yards for their children.
Have you found then in pressing the flesh, talking to voters, that there is this agreement, at least south of I-12, that we need to maybe slow down a bit?
That is what I'm hearing, yes, is, you know, we need to be smart about what's growing here, what's the development that's going on in our area of District 10 especially. Ponchatoula, as you know, Ken, it's grown by leaps and bounds. And so, yeah, we are hearing that from pretty much everyone saying that we need to just make smart decisions.
What about the Lake Maurepas issue, which is not per se a parish council issue, although the council did pass a resolution supporting what Bill Weed and Nikki Muscarella are trying to do to slow down the carbon sequestration project?
Yes, and that's something that I'm following very closely. You know, I grew up on the river. That is like a second home to me, and the lake is very precious to me and to my family as well. And so what we're hearing, especially from people in this area, is, you know, save our lake. We want to be able to preserve what we have. And so, you know, very appreciative that the committee passed that, so we'll have to see what happens next.
You know, thinking back to your dad, Julian Dewfresh, I remember about him that he was always a conservationist, even going back to the 1970s. And as you talk about these issues, I just can't help but realize that if he was here now today, he'd still be trying to save and preserve the Tanchpahoe River, and he'd be appalled at plans to industrialize Lake Maurepas.
You are 100% correct in that. Dad was definitely a conservationist. I call myself a conservationist as well. We need to protect what we have, like I said earlier. And, you know, my dad was, he loved to fish. He loved to hunt. And so I grew up on those waters. I grew up fishing with Dad. And yeah, you know, that's something that in this area, it's very precious. It's very dear to us. And we just appreciate the efforts that are going on right now.
What else do you want to tell us?
Well, I'm just really excited with the campaign. We are here in this beautiful area and at St. Joseph's School, and something that's really exciting each year is the spring fair. But we are going everywhere and anywhere that we're invited. And, you know, it's hard when you're in a local election. It's hard when you know all of the candidates because you've grown up with many of them. And you know, anywhere that we are invited, we're going to go because I have to meet people, and I'm just trying to get out there and shake hands and let people know what my purpose is and what my vision is for District 10. And so that's really what we're focusing on right now, is just getting out into the public, all of these wonderful events going on during this time of year, and just hoping to meet everyone.
Good.